Three Ravalli County men were charged this week with illegally killing at least 9 black bears with the aid of bait in both Ravalli and Beaverhead counties.
Little preview of what you'll be hearing here in just a moment. Good morning, everyone. This is Montana Morning. It is Friday. Congratulations, you made it. It's July 25th, 2014. We have a cloudy sky. We've got 48 degrees in Missoula right now. And this newscast this morning, sponsored by Diggit Excavating, where they bring 30 years of excellence to every job. Call 214-4292 or visit their website at diggitmontana.com. Our top story this morning, the U.S. Army War College says a group of faculty will be investigating whether Montana Democratic Senator John Walsh plagiarized a research project he submitted back in 2007. The college posted a statement on its website yesterday that says it determined there was reasonable cause to refer the case to the school's academic review board. Walsh will be allowed to submit material to the review board and attend its initial hearing. An Associated Press review of the paper confirmed Walsh included both conclusions and verbatim passages taken from the writings of other scholars. The Montana Democrats running against Republican Congressman Steve Daines to keep the seat to which he was appointed back in February. In a related story, Senator Walsh is learning that running for a highly competitive Senate seat brings intense scrutiny of almost everything he ever wrote or said publicly. The Montana Democrats coping with a New York Times report of apparent plagiarism in his 2007 master's thesis. Walsh blames post-traumatic stress disorder, partly to blame for his insufficiently crediting academic articles from which he borrowed heavily. Campaign operatives say the scoop looks like classic political opposition research. The goal is to fly-spec a candidate's history of comments, business dealings, legal actions, romances, health, writings, and countless other items in search of a flaw that might cripple that candidate's campaign. It's now more prevalent in well-financed Senate campaigns. Montana Fish, Wildlife, and Parks spokeswoman Vivica Krauser says game wardens have found three men they believe are responsible for one of the biggest black bear poaching cases in history.
Three Ravalli County men were charged this week with illegally killing at least 9 black bears with the aid of bait in both Ravalli and Beaverhead counties. And this has happened over a series of years. And one of the biggest cases that we've had statewide of black bear baiting and killing. They were just after the bears for their hides and skulls. So really after them for trophy, and we're leaving the meat to waste.
One of the men appeared in court Wednesday. The others will be in court soon.
Jimmy Harrison, 61, of Darby, was one of the men involved. And then also there, Kyle Weihard, 26, of Darby. And the third man was Richard Sublett, 56, of Hamilton.
All the men face multiple misdemeanor charges. Firefighters are well on their way to containing the Sear Gulch fire burning near the Deep Creek area on the west side of the Clark Fork. Fire Information Officer Jordan Copen has details.
As of now, it is 80% lined. We did have cool weather, so things have cooled down quite a bit. So our crews have been working hard to get that 80% lined. It's still at 47.8 acres.
Copen also has an update on a smaller fire nearby.
It was the second fire spotted south of the Sear Gulch, called the Haggerty Fire. The fire was lightning caused. About a quarter acre resources attacked it right away last night, and all it was basically was a burning snag. So it was contained and controlled, and now it's put on patrol, so there's no worries there.
Copen says while campfires are still being allowed, everyone should be sure that campfires are cold to the touch before leaving them. Open burning remains closed. There are no other restrictions at this time. He says he urges people to be careful with fire. A double check before recreating in Montana. Prosecutors are recommending 23 consecutive life sentences without the possibility of parole for a man they called a sadistic stalker who was convicted of 10 counts of rape in Billings. The Billings Gazette reports 42-year-old Toby Grigo is scheduled to be sentenced today by District Judge Russell Fagg. Grigo was convicted in April of breaking into the homes of four women last year, repeatedly raping three of them and trying to rape the fourth. Montana high school students who use the free courses provided by the Code Montana Project will have the opportunity this year to get college credit for their efforts. Code Montana Project and Right Now Technologies founder Greg Gianforte explains.
We introduced the program just about a year ago, and we're excited to announce that students that participate this fall in Code Montana, which is free of charge, have the option of registering and getting college credit. So they'd actually get 3 credits equivalent to an intro to programming class that's going to prepare them for their college career.
To get credit, students will need to register and pay about $150 to enroll at the class via Montana Tech, who will provide an adjunct professor to grade the student's work.
It's being done through Montana Tech in Butte, but these three credits that you receive are transferable. So you could transfer them to U of M or MSU. I believe you could also transfer them to another school. This is full college credit. You're essentially enrolled at Montana Tech, although you do the work online, so you can just do it from home after school or maybe with a group of kids at school.
One of the original goals of Code Montana was to get students interested in the technology sector and give them a shot at the hundreds of new tech jobs that are popping up in the state with starting salaries between $45,000 and $85,000. City of Missoula Street Division crews begin applying oil and chips to city streets. As of Monday, in the city's annual Chip Seal Street Maintenance Program, City Street Division Superintendent Brian Hensel explains the importance of chip sealing.
Chip sealing is probably one of the most effective asphalt maintenance techniques in the industry. It allows you to cover a large area at a fairly economic price. And it would be similar to as if you built a new house and you wanted to paint it.
Hensel also says chip sealing is one of the best techniques to avoid potholes.
The biggest cause of potholes is from moisture getting into cracks and causing potholes. Well, this helps provide an additional moisture barrier on asphalt. So yeah, it's a perfect method for helping prevent potholes.
The project will begin Monday and wrap up on the 31st, weather permitting. The Blue Mountain Observatory will be holding an open house after sunset tonight. University of Montana astronomy and math professor Diane Friend explains.
We have a 16-inch telescope in a nice dark sky location, and we are able to take a look at all kinds of things, whatever's up. So right now there's a couple planets up. We can see Mars and Saturn, and we are able to see nebulas, star birth regions, star death regions, distant galaxies, star clusters, a whole host of things.
Astronomers will also be on hand to give more insight into the night sky.
We usually also have one or more 8-inch telescopes set up outside the dome, so you can look at objects while you're waiting to look through the big telescope. And we'll do star talks where we talk about constellations and stars and other deep sky objects that you can see with the naked eye or binoculars. Talk a little bit about star lore and answer any questions people have about what's happening in astronomy today.
Last year's open house opportunities were smoked out by that Lolo Creek Complex fire. News Talk time now, 6:10.
News Talk, KGVO.
Missoula's official weather station.
A building ridge of high pressure will bring ample sunshine and very warm temperatures to the region as we head into the weekend. Today will be quite comfortable with their highs in the upper 70s. We'll be in the 90s by Sunday. I'm meteorologist Brooke Foster for KECI 13.